Today we will focus on the formation of urine. So what is formation of urine? The urine formation is generally a blood cleansing function, and normally 1300 milliliters of blood passes through the kidney per minute. That is approximately 26% of the cardiac output. So we'll write what is urine formation. It is basically a blood cleansing function. And every minute there is 1300 milliliters of blood passing through the kidney. So 1300 per minute. That is approximately 26% of the cardiac output. And kidneys excrete the unwanted substances along with the water from the blood as urine. And the normal urine output per day is 1 to 1.5 liters. So the normal output of urine is 1 to 1.5 liters. So now, to understand about the formation of urine, we have divided them into three important phases. So we should know the three phases of formation of urine in order to completely understand what is happening during this blood cleansing function. So what are the three phases? The first phase is glomerular filtration. Which is the function of the glomerulus. We did a previous video on the basic structure of the nephron. If you have time, you can go and look at that so that you can understand what glomerulus is. And the second phase is tubular reabsorption, and the third phase is tubular secretion. So these three phases are very important to know how the formation of urine takes place. Now we will see each of them in detail. Now we will speak about the first phase, that is the glomerular filtration. The glomerular filtration is nothing but the blood which is filtered while passing through the glomerular capillaries through the filtration membrane. We will see a picture to understand this better. Now here we see the basic structure of the nephron. While speaking about the basic structure of nephron, we spoke that it has two main parts, that is the glomerular part and the tubular part. I'll draw a line here to differentiate. So this is the glomerular part, and this here is the tubular part, which we spoke in an earlier video. And now we'll concentrate on the glomerular part as we are looking at the first phase, that is the glomerular filtration. So through this efferent arteriole, which we see here, the blood passes through the efferent arteriole, and through this group of tuft of capillaries, the blood gets to filter. And what are the membranes that help in this filtration process is, the entire filtration membrane is formed by the glomerular capillary membrane, which comprises of the capillaries, the group of the capillaries, followed by the basement membrane, which denotes the Bowman's capsule, which encloses the group of the capillaries. And we also have the visceral layer of the Bowman's capsule, which also helps in the filtration process. And histologically, we saw that these places has some kind of the filtration pores, which are also called as the fenestrae. So if you see the earlier video, you can understand how these parts have special things which help in the filtration processes. And how does the process takes place? So when the blood passes through the glomerular capillaries through the efferent arteriole, the plasma is filtered in the Bowman's capsule. So as soon as the blood enters the afferent arteriole, the plasma starts to get filtered with the help of the Bowman's capsule, and all the substances in the plasma are filtered except the plasma proteins, because the filtration membrane which is present in the Bowman's capsule are very smaller, and the plasma proteins, for example albumins, globulins, they have a larger molecular size. So these proteins are taken back into the blood, and this filtered fluid which comes out of the glomerulus is called the glomerular filtrate, and this is considered to be as the primary urine. So after this filtration, we get around 150 to 180 liters of liquid, which we say as the primary urine, and water, electrolytes, glucose, vitamins are all filtered in this processes. So now we'll write, so the entire process takes place only in the glomerulus, which includes the group of the capillaries and the Bowman's capsule. And now we'll write the important things that we spoke about the glomerular filtration. So now, so the what is the glomerular filtration? The blood which is filtered while passing through glomerular capillaries and the glomerular capillaries via the filtration membrane. And we came to know what are these filtration membrane. The filtration membrane comprises of the glomerular capillary membrane, the basement membrane, and the visceral layer of the Bowman's capsule. So these three act as the filtration membrane for the blood to get filtered. So we'll just name what are these filtration membrane. The filtration membrane comprises of the glomerular capillary membrane, and the basement membrane, that is the outer part of the Bowman's capsule where the group of the capillaries are enclosed within it, and we have the visceral layer of the Bowman's capsule. Now we will speak how this glomerular filtration takes place. Already I gave an insight of how this process takes place, so I will explain once again. So when the plasma enters through this afferent arteriole, the blood gets to pass through the group of the capillaries, and through the help of the filtration membranes, the plasma gets to be filtered. And all the electrolytes, vitamins, glucose, and water are filtered except for the plasma proteins, because they have a large molecular size. So we'll write the important points regarding this glomerular filtration. So we'll write the process. So how does this process takes place? So once the blood passes, the blood enters glomerulus, and plasma filtered with the help of the filtration membrane. So what is the filtration membrane? You can see all these three things which help in the filtration of the blood. So plasma filtered, all the components of the blood including the vitamins, water, electrolytes are all filtered in this process except for the plasma proteins. So plasma proteins not filtered because of the large molecular size. and the end product which comes through the efferent arteriole is called as the glomerular filtrate. So the filtered blood after this process is called as the glomerular filtrate, which is otherwise called as the primary urine. Which is around 150 to 180 liters. So this is all about the glomerular filtration. Now we'll see the second phase of the formation of urine, which is about the tubular reabsorption. So the second phase is tubular reabsorption. So as far as the glomerular filtration, the entire process takes place in the glomerulus, which is the first part of the nephron, and the other two phases, that is the tubular reabsorption and the tubular secretion, depends on the tubular portion of the nephron, which is the second portion. So what is tubular reabsorption? As the name itself suggests, it is the process by which water and other substances are transferred from the renal tubules back to the blood. So from the glomerular filtrate, some substances are transferred back to the blood. So this process is the tubular reabsorption. We look at the picture to get a clearer insight. So here we see the picture. Now we have to focus on the second phase, that is the tubular reabsorption. So after the first phase, the urine tends to flow from the Bowman's capsule, descending downwards towards the tubular portion. And when the glomerular filtrate flows through the tubular portion of the nephron, there is some qualitative and quantitative changes that takes place. So in this portion, that is when the urine enters the proximal convoluted tubule, which is over here, the large quantity of water, electrolytes and other substances are reabsorbed. Large quantity of water, in the sense almost 99% of the water gets to be reabsorbed, and electrolytes and other substances are also reabsorbed, and all these reabsorbed substances move into the interstitial fluid of the renal medulla, and from there the substances move into the blood through the peritubular capillaries. So when we consider that the glomerular filtrate, that is the filtrate that comes from the Bowman's capsule, consisted of 150 to 180 liters. When 99% of the water is reabsorbed, only 1% leaves through the convoluted tubules. That is 1.5 to 1.8 liters leaves through the convoluted tubule. And this is considered to be the secondary urine, which is obviously excreted and eliminated from our body. And now we'll write some important points about the second phase. So what is tubular reabsorption? Some things gets to be reabsorbed into the body from the convoluted tubules. So there is some qualitative and quantitative changes. So what happens is large quantity of water, that is almost 99% of the glomerular filtrate gets to be reabsorbed, along with the electrolytes, gets to be reabsorbed. And all these reabsorbed fluids get to enter into the blood. So when 99% of the water gets reabsorbed, the remaining 1.5 to 1.8 liters is the normal excreted urine from our body. And this content of urine is said to be the secondary urine, which is eliminated. And in this tubular reabsorption, water and electrolytes undergo passive reabsorption, that is, they are transported without any usage of energy because they tend to move from the area of the higher concentration to the lower concentration through itself. So water and electrolytes are transported by itself. Undergo passive reabsorption, that is without any need of energy. Whereas proteins, glucose and vitamins undergo active transportation, which requires some energy for them to go back into the blood. So proteins, glucose and vitamins undergo active reabsorption, which requires energy. And another important thing is, we go to the picture. So as soon as the glomerular filtrate comes to the proximal convoluted tubule, we have to remember that almost 85% of the substances are reabsorbed in the proximal convoluted tubule and only 15% are reabsorbed in the distal convoluted tubule over here. So the amount of reabsorption takes place initially and only 15% takes place in the distal convoluted tubules. And other toxins, waste and metabolic products and ammonium including uric acid, they don't undergo any reabsorption in this process. So these are ultimately toxins and they need to be eliminated from our body. So all these things doesn't undergo any changes. And we'll write the other important point, that is almost 85% of the substances reabsorbed in proximal convoluted tubules. Convoluted tubules. And only 15% in distal convoluted tubules. And other waste doesn't undergo any changes in the tubular reabsorption. They just flow through the next part of the tubular. And now we'll see about the third phase of the urine formation, that is about the tubular secretion. And as you can see, the name itself suggests that some things are going to be secreted to the tubular portion, that is some substances come from the blood to the tubules. And this is an active process where the movement of materials from blood come into the tubular fluid. And the substances that are secreted from the blood include the hydrogen ions, potassium ions, ammonium ions, creatinine and other drugs, which obviously are metabolic wastes so that they can easily get eliminated from our body. And there are two important effects regarding this tubular secretion which we will see in a bit. So we'll write about the tubular secretion. So this is an active process where materials from the blood enter the tubules. And the substances that enter the tubules from the blood include the hydrogen ions, that is all these ions come from blood into the tubular portion. So hydrogen ions, potassium ions, ammonium ions, creatinine, which is a waste from the muscles, and other drugs. and all these things are actually wastes which are to be disposed from our body. And the two important effects through this phase in the formation of urine include the tubular secretion. This phase controls the pH of the blood. Because of the secretion of the hydrogen ions, it helps to maintenance of the pH of the blood, and the secretion of other substances, that is the leftovers from the drugs, are all wastes and toxins, and these toxins are eliminated from the body so that the homeostasis of the body is maintained. So two main effects which take place in this process are control of blood pH because of the secretion of the hydrogen ions into the tubular portion. So control of blood pH and the other one is elimination of wastes from the body. So as a conclusion and the summary of the urine formation, you have to know the three phases. The first one is the glomerular filtration, where the plasma is filtered in this region, where the plasma is filtered in the glomeruli and the substances reach the renal tubules along with the water as the glomerular filtrate enters into the proximal convoluted tubule, where the second phase takes place. So we'll name it here as the first phase. Here is the first phase. And here is the second phase in the tubular portion. And what happens in the second phase is the 99% of the glomerular filtrate is reabsorbed in different segments of the renal tubule. But you have to understand that almost 85% of absorption takes place in the proximal convoluted tubule and 15% in the distal convoluted tubules. And the third phase is the tubular secretion that takes place around here near the collecting ducts. And in the tubular secretion, some substances are transported from the blood into the tubular portion. So from blood it comes into the tubular portion, assuming there is some arteries over here, and things entering into the distal portion of the tubular portion, and the substances are transported from the blood into the renal tubule. With all these changes which takes place in all these three phases, the filtrate ultimately becomes the urine, and the urine is excreted from our body.